Welcome class, welcome to this digital platform and here I am Twinkle to connect with you for your English class and in this class I am going to teach you the chapter 1 of your grammar book and the name of the chapter 1 has been already written on the blackboard. You can see that the sentence. So I am going to tell you what are the sentence and how to use it. Okay, so let's start your class. So first I will tell you the meaning of sentence. A meaning of sentence mean a group of words that expresses the complete meaning. Okay, a group of words. Suppose here for an example I am writing, Ankur was playing cricket. Okay class, so you can see in the blackboard that I have already written a sentence, Ankur was playing cricket. Okay, so in the sentence you can see the first letter of the sentence, that must be capital, and in the end of the sentences we must have to put some signs. So what are these signs? Okay, we will understand that as per the examples. Okay, it's the first example. Okay, the next example I'm writing here, where are you going? So you can see the next sentence I have written on the blackboard, that where are you going? Okay, okay, the next sentence I'm gonna write, what an idea. What an idea. Okay, you can see in these three sentences I have put different signs in the end of the sentences. You can see the first and the fourth, in the fourth sentence I have put a full stop. This sign is called full stop. Okay, so you can see in the fourth sentence I have put a full stop in the end of the sentence. You can see in the second sentence, where are you going? This is a question mark sentence. You can tell it is the interrogative sentence. Where are you going? You can see that in the end of the sentences I have already put this a sign, and a sign is called question mark. Okay, so how do you recognize the question mark sentences in the sentence? So you can see this question start with the WH word, and you know that where, what, how. So these questions, these words are coming from WH words. If a sentence begins with a WH word, so you must have to put a full question mark in the end of the sentence. Okay, one more thing, you can see the third example, what an idea. Here I have put a sign, and this sign is called exclamatory sign. Okay, so these three important sign we already got. First one is full stop, second one is question mark, and the third one is exclamatory mark. So I would like to, where we do we use the exclamatory sign? Okay, so an exclamatory sentence on that express a stress on forcefully emotion such as anger, surprise or joy. So in this sentence we may add this exclamatory sign. So what an idea. Here I am very much surprised. If for an example I would like to tell that I faced a difficulty and I need a suggest from my friend, and one of my friends gave an amazing suggest what I never expected. So that time I was very much shocked, and in surprise I told to my friend, what an idea. Okay, so it expresses the strong feelings. Okay, and that's surprise. Okay, complete understood where do we use the exclamatory sign and the question mark. If a sentence start with a WH word or an auxiliary verb, means you can tell that a helping verb, if the question start with these three words, so you may put in the end of the sentence a sign, and that is called question mark. Okay, as I already told you about the full stop, in the end of the sentence you can put a full stop, and you can see in these three sentences it is conveying the complete meaning. Okay, these three sentences are expressing the complete meaning. Ankur was playing cricket. What was being played by Ankur? Cricket. He was being played by Ankur. Where are you going? Okay, after that here already the question mark has been put. Okay, what an idea. This is an exclamatory sign because it's complete expressing of feeling of surprise. Okay, complete So we knew that two things, how to identify a sentence. There is two things just keep in your mind that you can see in these sentences what I've already written on the blackboard. First one is A, second one is W, and third one is W. In these three sentences, the first letter must be capital in a sentence. Okay? Like that Ankur was playing cricket, the first letter of the sentence is A, so that must be capital. Okay, so W is where are you going here? W must be capital here also. W written in the capital. Okay, so don't write in the small letter. Okay, if you will write, suppose Ankur is a good boy. Okay, good boy. Yes, I understood that. You have already put a full stop here, but this sentence is wrong. Why the reason? What the reason? So reason is that here we know that we already have little bit idea about it. The first letter of a proper noun that must be capital in a sentence. Okay. So here also Ankur is a proper noun and leave that. The sentence first letter what? A. Okay. So here it is A is in a small letter. So this sentence will be wrong. Okay. So understood? One more thing. You can see in this sentence there is a more than one word, which is called a sentence. As I already told you, a group of words that expresses the complete meaning. You can see there is not one word, more than one words in a sentence. Okay, so you can see that a group of words that call a sentence. Okay, we understood that. Okay, you understood that three signs what you will put. But whenever we speak, it is not possible to tell after a sentence, my name is Rita Rani Satpathy full stop, I read in standard 3 full stop. So we can't tell that, but in a full stop we obey that, and for how many seconds? Only 2 to 3 seconds we must to stop in a full stop whenever we read a book. But whenever we write something, that is most important to keep in our mind these signs. One is full stop, any signs, any quotation mark you may use whenever you write something. That is most important. Okay, otherwise your letter, your sentences will be not considered. This little thing I want to say to you. One more thing I would like to tell. On my birthday. As you know, a sentence containing a verb with a object part. Okay, that just keep in your mind. A sentence always containing a verb with an object part. Okay, so on my birthday. Here I am writing another sentence. On my birthday. What is on my birthday? There is something. There is nothing. It is not expressing a complete meaning, is it? Not. So this sentence is not expressing a complete meaning. So we can't tell it is a correct sentence. So it is incorrect because it's not what's on my birthday, your birthday, what your birthday, what on my birthday. There is everything is missing in this part. So we can't tell this sentence is a sentence. No, it is not a sentence because it's not containing a verb as well as. On my birthday, I have already told you there is some signs. There is no sign. You can see clearly that there is no signs on my birthday, and this is not expressing a complete meaning. That's why this sentence is wrong. Okay. I'm writing Is there any water? So anyone can tell me that what is wrong in the sentence? I think everything is correct. No, here I omitted the sign. What is most important in the writing part, as I already told you. Okay, so is there any water? That means here is no sign. No sign has been given here. So we can't tell it is a correct sentence. It's an incorrect sentence. Okay, you can see now you look at these three examples and the above three examples. Ankur was playing cricket. There are more than words, not only one words. A more than group of words has been given, more than words are in this first sentence. Ankur was playing cricket and it expressed the complete meaning. So after that there is a full stop, there is a capital letter in the beginning of the sentence. So this sentence is okay, it's expressing a complete meaning, so we can tell this sentence is correct. Second sentence, where are you going? Here this question, as I already told you, if a sentence starts with a WH word, otherwise the auxiliary word, so you in the end of the sentence you can put a question mark, not a full stop. Okay, if where are you going, if after the end of the sentence if you put a full stop, then the sentence will be incorrect, okay? Because the sentence starts with the WH words. Now come to the third example, what an idea. As I already told you, it's a feeling, and I'm very much surprised about the idea. So you can see, there is a confusing arising in your mind is that here is WH word, as I already told you, here is WH word. But the difference is that in this sentence, where are you going? The question was asking to someone. Okay, so that's why we are putting, but we want to know the answer. Okay, so that's why we put here question mark. But here, what an idea, that means it's expressed a strong or forceful emotion such as surprise. Okay, so here I am very much surprised. So that's why I am using the exclamatory sign. You may pick out any sentences, what a starry night, what a cinetic beauty. You may like this sentence, you may pick out many sentences with the exclamatory sign, okay? So next, you can see in the below sentences, Ankur is playing good with this sentence is not correct. Why? Because the sentence first letter here is small. So it is not a complete sentence. So on my birthday, this is not containing any verb, any object part with it. And on my birthday, this is not expressing a complete meaning. So we can tell it is a sentence. You can see in the end of the sentence, is there any water? Here I omitted a sign. Which sign will be used to correct here? Okay, question mark. Okay, because the sentence starts with the auxiliary verb or helping verb each. Okay. So if I will put here a question mark, then the sentence will be correct. If I have omitted it here, I have already omitted it, so you can put a wrong sign because it's not expressing a complete meaning. Without sign, without the capital letter, you can call this is the sentence. Okay. So it is enough for today. We will meet in the next class with some question answer of chapter 1. Till then, keep learning. Tata, have a good day.